To start, unscrew the electrode screw mount and lift out the piston. Then align a 10 by 10 millimeter plate electrode so that it's flush against the gasket. Let's slide the piston back in and retighten the screw mount. This will ensure our electrode is snug and secure. Then, simply repeat the same for the other half of the cell. Moving on, we'll access the inner section of the cell. To do this, open the metal clasps at the same time and gently pull apart the cell halves. If the gaskets give you a bit of a struggle, a pair of tweezers works wonders. After separating them, make sure to place the gaskets back in their original positions. Now, depending on the experiment you're running, you'll place either your metal alloy or a permeable membrane onto one of these gaskets. Gently apply pressure to make sure it adheres properly. For those conducting hydrogen permeation experiments, remember to connect this metal electrode to the tantalum clip. Next, let's reunite our cell halves. Ensure they align using these handy alignment pins. Before sealing them, adjust the clamping force of these clasps by rotating their head. Check that there is even spacing between the two cell halves to ensure a gas-tight seal. Let's shift our focus to the reference electrodes. Firstly, remove the plug from this adapter, then slot in an O-ring. Make sure it sits flush against the lip of the inset. It might be a bit fiddly, that's where your trusty tweezers come in. Next, take the cap off the reference electrode and give it a gentle tap. This will get rid of any sneaky bubbles hiding by the frit. Lastly for this step, with a bit of a twist, push the reference electrode into its holder. And, as before, repeat for the opposite cell half. Almost there. Now for our electrolyte. We're demonstrating using a static electrolyte today, but the process is pretty similar if you're using a flow cell. Firstly, with a syringe, introduce the electrolyte into the cell. Keep an eye out for the liquid level appearing in this outlet tubing. Once you spot it, clamp that tube shut. Continue adding a smidge more electrolyte until you spot the liquid in the reference electrode outlet port. Seal this one too, and then, as with our previous steps, repeat for the other half. The Devanathan-Stachurski cell is now ready for you to perform electrochemical experiments with. Now let's disassemble. Begin by unclamping the clip on the reference electrode tubing. Withdraw a modest amount of liquid. Subsequently, release the second clip and extract the remaining electrolyte. Do this for the other half of the cell. Upon removing the electrolyte, detach the syringes from the cell. To remove the reference electrodes, apply a gentle twisting and pulling motion. Once removed, clean the electrode and promptly replace its cap. This ensures the integrity and cleanliness of the electrode. Unfasten the clasps and separate the cell halves gently. Next, let's get those polarising electrodes out. Unscrew the holder and remove the piston, and using your tweezers, take out the plate electrode. If you notice any corrosion on the copper piston, simply repolish it to return it back to its pristine condition. To access the polarising electrode gasket, start by unscrewing the four dedicated screws. Once separated, utilise tweezers to remove the gasket. Introduce a clean gasket as a replacement. Position the plate back onto the cell. Align the plate utilizing the alignment holes and proceed to screw it back into place. It is recommended to tighten the screws in a cross pattern, ensuring even pressure distribution over the gasket. After cleaning, reassemble the cell and then repeat for the other cell half. Reunite the two halves of the cell, ensuring a correct alignment, and subsequently clamp them together. Concluding the disassembly process, ensure that any previously removed plugs are securely repositioned. The Devanathan-Stachurski cell is now disassembled and ready for storage. If you have any questions about our electrochemical cells, please visit our website.